In this short video, I'll show you the steps on how to find an area given z-scores using normal CDF or normal cumulative distribution function, and how to find z-scores from a known area using invNorm function, the inverse of normal CDF, on the TI-84 graphing calculator.
We will work with the same example from the previous video when we calculated the area using table A2 and StatCrunch. Let's just read the example one more time. A bone mineral density test can be helpful in identifying the presence or likelihood of osteoporosis. The result of a bone density test is commonly measured as a z-score. The population of z-scores is normally distributed with the mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. So these results meet the requirements of a standard normal distribution. Part 1. A randomly selected adult undergoes a bone density test. Find the probability that this person has a bone density test score less than 1.27. I'm going to draw a diagram just to help us visualize what area we're looking for. Mean is equal 0. Standard deviation is equal 1. 1.27 will be located somewhere right here. Less than 1.27. Well, area less means it will be to the left of the z-score. So this is p of x less than 1.27. In TI-84 graphing calculator, go to second bars to get to distribution. Go to normal CDF, normal cumulative distribution function, enter. In the normal CDF, you will need to enter lower limit, upper limit, mean, and standard deviation. Lower limit is left border, which in this case, it will be negative infinity. Well, there is no infinity sign in the graphing calculator. So instead of writing negative infinity, we put the small number -1e99 means -1 × 10⁻⁹. So it's pretty far to the left. Or you can also type -99999. Just be careful when you type negative, put the negative sign, not the minus sign. This is the negative sign right here. Since we already have negative infinity for the left limit, let's change the upper limit, the right limit, 1.27, our z-score. Mu is 0, sigma is 1. Enter. Enter again. The area to the left of the z-score of 1.27 is 0.89795 rounded to 4 decimals, will be 0.89980. Let's do the next part. Using the same bone density test, find the probability that a randomly selected person has a result above -1.00, which is considered to be the normal range of a bone density reading. Again, let's draw a diagram. It will help us visualize where the area that we're looking for located. Mean is 0. Negative 1 would be 1 to the left of 0. And we are looking for probability of x above negative 1. So x is greater than negative 1. Greater than negative 1 will be on the right side of negative 1. In the graphing calculator, go to second, vars, normal CDF. Now we're going to change the lower limit to negative 1. Negative 1. You can type 0.00, but you don't have to put the zeros. Upper limit. Now, upper limit is to the very, very right. So you can type 1e99, or you can type 99999 to indicate the large number way, way, way to the right. I'm going to type 99999, mean 0, standard deviation 1. Enter. Enter again. The area to the right of the z-score of negative 1 is equal to 0.8413 rounded to 4 decimals. Let's do the last part. A bone density reading between negative 1 and negative 2.5 indicates the subject has osteopenia, which is some bone loss. Find the probability that a randomly selected subject has a reading between negative 1.00 and negative 2.5. And of course, we are going to draw a diagram first. And in the diagram, we are going to indicate our two z-scores, negative 1 and negative 2.5. This is 0 in the middle. Negative 1 will be closer to 0, and then negative 2.5 will be farther from 0. So we are looking for the area or probability that is located between these two scores. Notice that the first score on the left is negative 2.5, and the score on the right is negative 1. In the graphing calculator, go to second bars to get to distribution, and we need normal CDF. For the lower limit, we will enter negative 2.5. For the upper limit, we're going to enter negative 1. Enter. Enter again. The area that is located between negative 2.5 and negative 1 is equal to 0.1524. Or we can say that there is 15.24% that a randomly selected subject will have a reading between negative 1 and negative 2.5. We'll now reverse the format to find the z-scores, knowing the areas. We're going to be using the same example with the bone mineral density test. It has a standard normal distribution. The first question is to find the bone density score corresponding to P95, or the 95th percentile. Remember, percentile is the mark that separates the lowest 95% from the highest 5%. So we will be looking for the z-score that separates the area of 95% to the left of that z-score. In the graphing calculator, go to second, vars, down to invNorm, or you can type 3. The area to the left is 0.95. Mean is 0, standard deviation 1. Make sure to check the tail. In this case, it's located on the left. Enter. Enter again. The z-score is 1.645. We're going to round this score to 3 decimals. This is a special z-score. Usually, z-scores are rounded to 2 decimals. Now, let's read part 2. Find the bone density test score that separates the bottom 2.5% and find the score that separates the top 2.5%. In the diagram, we can see that 2.5% is a very, very small area on the left, 0.025 as a decimal. So we'll be looking for the z-score. And 2.5% to the right is very, very tiny area to the right of that z-score. So first let's find the z-score that separates 0.025 on the left of that z-score. Go to second, vars, invNorm, enter. Area to the left is 0.025. Enter. Enter again. It's negative 1.96, rounded to 2 decimals. Now, without calculating on the calculator, the z-score that separates the area of 0.025 to the right of the z-score, let's guess. Because the graph is symmetrical, we can guess that the z-score that separates 0.025 on the right will also be 1.96. But let's check on the calculator. Go to second, vars, invNorm, enter. Now we're going to change it to area or tail to the right. Enter. 1.96. We were right. That's because the graph of a normal distribution is symmetrical, bell-shaped. I hope that was helpful.